Honorable Senators, I rise today grateful to be on Algonquin Anishinaabe territory to actually share some sad news with you. On August 7th, the community of East Preston, and actually all African Nova Scotians, bid farewell to our beloved matriarch, centenarian, 105-year-old Eliza Brooks. There's an African principle called Nia, which means purpose. Reflecting on Miss Eliza, I'm reminded of that African principle, Nia, or purpose. She lived an inspiring life full of love, spirituality, determination, and purpose. Denied access to education, she worked as a domestic and an institutional cleaner. But she was determined to make life better for her family. As a single mother of four, she was no stranger to poverty. There were many times when they had to eat porridge 3 times a day, without milk or sugar or even molasses, with no complaints allowed. I can just imagine her saying, well, at least they had 3 meals a day. She taught her children to value education, to value life. She took the time to teach other basic life skills to help foster independence, like cooking and baking, sewing and gardening. Miss Eliza was deeply spiritual, and she was an active member of the East Preston United Baptist Church for over 70 years. She sang in the choir until a few months before her death. And at the tender age of 104, she released her first CD. Felicia Chandler of CBC Information Morning in Halifax interviewed her for her 105th birthday celebration in May. When asked about her secret to a long life, or you want to listen to this, she said that every single day she went for a walk, then she did her chores, then had a cup of tea. I'm inspired to live a life like hers. I'm inspired to keep walking every day. I'm inspired to bring joy to someone's life every single day and to help others find their purpose. Honorable Senators, please join me in sending condolences to her children, Deacon Fred, Phyllis, Robert Sr., and Philip, their spouses, her grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and to the community of East Preston. Rest in peace, dear Eliza Victoria Brooks. Certainly you have earned it. Asante. Thank you.